Well, also breaking in North Jersey tonight, a deadly shooting at the home of a federal judge. Police say a gunman shot and killed the son of U.S. District Judge Esther Salas and injured her husband at their North Brunswick home.
A federal judge's son is shot dead and her criminal defense attorney husband is critically injured when a guy disguised as a FedEx driver ambushes their home. Oh, 4 days after she's assigned a case that's linked to Jeffrey Epstein, who didn't kill himself. But it's all a coincidence. I'm sure it's just a coincidence. Do yourself a favor right now, click on the link in the description, grab my code, and get a massive discount on this ultra-bright rechargeable survival flashlight. You can hang it on any metal surface, it's durable, the charge lasts forever, you don't need batteries because it's powered by the sun or with a wall outlet, you can use it to charge your cell phone from 0 to 100%, it's got multiple emergency flashing modes, plus a shop light function. There's a glass breaker, a seatbelt cutter, a compass, and an emergency siren. Guys, this thing is freaking bright. Grab one while you can. The link's in the description.
Coming up on 9:30, I want to tell you the 20-year-old son of a federal judge is now dead after a shooting at the family's home in New Jersey. Law enforcement officials say the judge's husband, who also answered the door, was shot late yesterday, as well as U.S. District Judge Esther Salas, who is seated in Newark, is believed to be unharmed. Authorities believe the gunman was wearing a FedEx uniform, but it's not clear whether that person is actually an employee.
According to reports, Judge Salas had recently been assigned to a civil financial fraud case tied to Jeffrey Epstein. It was brought by Deutsche Bank investors who claimed the bank made false and misleading statements about its anti-money laundering policies and failed to monitor high-risk customers, including convicted sex offender billionaire Jeffrey Epstein. Now, when you're talking about banks like Deutsche Bank, you're talking about a centrally controlled bank. Centrally controlled banks are controlled by the Federal Reserve, and the Federal Reserve is controlled by the Zio cult tied to the Mossad. Now, according to reports, Epstein and Robert Maxwell, that's Ghislaine's father, were tied to the same crime ring. So this all stinks of a cover-up. Earlier this month, the bank agreed to pay a $150 million fine, which I'm sure taxpayers footed the bill for continuing to work with Epstein after he was convicted of soliciting underage prostitutes in 2008. That sounds like it might be a red herring cover story. Here are some testimonies of the neighbors and friends.
It's sad to see him go. I mean, he was a decent kid, like, you know, going to be a lawyer just like his dad did. His father's a lawyer. Sad to see him go. I mean, my prayers go out to the family, of course. You know, they're good people. Everything is just sad to see him go. I'm shocked.
I was just out of my door. My daughter opened the door for me. I hear the very loud gunshots, probably 3 times or around there.
Four.
Definitely more than 2. And then I walk into my car. I saw another car parked across the street and someone get into a car and drive away. I hear the judge's family are making call, you know. At that moment, I still didn't realize there was a crime scene or whatever. So I drive onto the US-1. I saw a lot of cops car coming this way. So I immediately realized there was something happening in my area. I hear real wrong gunshots. So I call my wife, say, probably something happened in the street. I probably saw the suspect, but I don't know that something happened, you know, horrible happened. And he walked to his car and drive away, but not in a very hurry mode. So I didn't see anything very abnormal, so I didn't pay attention to something.
What kind of car was it?
I was questioned by the FBI and the cop yesterday. I didn't pay attention. I just remember it was a bigger car.
My husband, 83, started crying. I mean, we're very close to that family. I was hysterical. I mean, because we knew Daniel, and because just thinking of his being an only child. Because when I saw Mark outside, I said, there are cars, 5 or 6 cars, Connecticut, New Hampshire. He said, no, Daniel invited some of his classmates.
According to other reports, Judge Salas also sent TV stars Teresa and Joe Giudice from The Real Housewives of New Jersey to jail for tax evasion and fraud. And you know there's got to be plenty of surveillance footage. This wasn't exactly a low-income area. These are nice houses in a nice neighborhood, and rich people like to keep an eye on things. Now, as with any of these cases that has any tie to a friend of the Clintons, it was highly speculated that if this truly did happen the way mainstream media is heavily reporting it did, and that's highly unlikely, people wondered if the guy who committed the crime wouldn't soon be found dead with a couple of bullet holes to the back of the noggin. And sure enough, while I'm doing this video, reports were coming out that they found the guy.
Now, breaking news, we have just learned that the man accused of killing the son of a federal judge in New Jersey and shooting her husband has been found dead. Police say the shooter showed up at the North Brunswick home of the judge dressed as a FedEx driver, and when the son answered the door, he opened fire. The husband of Judge Esther Salas is now in critical condition. She was in the basement of the home and is unharmed. But again, the suspect, that police are telling us, has been found dead, and they're saying by suicide.
By suicide.
Here's how the Counterfeit News Network is reporting on it. Suspect in shooting a federal judge's son and husband at her New Jersey home has died, sources say. The person suspected of shooting the husband and son of U.S. District Court of New Jersey Esther Salas on Sunday at her North Brunswick home has died of what is believed to be a self-inflicted gunshot wound, according to two law enforcement sources. Both the U.S. Marshals and the FBI, of course, are investigating the shooting and were working to find the suspected gunman. Initial reports from law enforcement said Daniel Adderall opened the door with his father right behind him. The door opened to a hail of gunfire and the gunman fled, the law enforcement source told CNN. According to a law enforcement official with direct knowledge of the investigation, they told CNN the gunman appeared to be wearing a FedEx uniform. A FedEx package addressed to Salas was found by officials investigating a vehicle associated with the suspect, according to a law enforcement source. And according to another law enforcement source and a second law enforcement source, the suspect was discovered in Liberty, New York. They say it is not yet known whether the gunman was a FedEx employee or someone posing to be an employee. A spokesman for FedEx said in an email statement, "We are aware of the media reports and are fully cooperating with the investigating authorities." Well, I gotta be careful how much I say on this channel about this situation, but I wanna know what your thoughts are. Leave them for the world and the Google Thought Police in the comments section below. If you enjoy these videos and you wanna support the channel, the best way you can do that is free. Just give this video a like and share it with everybody you know everywhere you can on social media. Guys, that helps out a lot. It helps me overcome the YouTube censorship from the Silicon Valley Thought Police and the mainstream media propaganda machine. I'll see you guys in the next heavily censored, shadow banned, and now 100% demonetized video. Do not forget to join me every night at 7:30 p.m. Central Standard Time on DLive. That's where you're going to get my uncensored content.
We've seen some crazy crap happen in the past month that we never thought would happen in the United States of America. People fighting over toilet paper and disinfectant sprays, reports coming in from all over the place of empty store shelves, no meat, no chicken, no eggs, the rice is gone. The last thing you want to do is be at a store fighting over food with the rest of the lemmings. But you can sidestep all that by going to my website, preparewithhighimpactflix.com, where you can pick up a couple months worth of delicious, nutritious, 2,000 calorie a day food that can store for up to 25 years. The site is preparewithhighimpactflix.com, and I'll throw that in the description and in the pinned comment for you. Never underestimate the power of stupid people in large crowds. It's better to have a food supply and not need it than to need it and not have it.